Good morning, Standard 6. Now today I am going to start Chapter 2 of Geography, which is about the continents and oceans. In this chapter, I will discuss about the surface of the earth. I will explain about the major continents and oceans, about major landforms and water bodies. Along with it, I will also mention you about the other landforms and water bodies. And finally, I will discuss about the importance of landforms and water bodies. So students, now let's be ready, and please, if you have atlas, have it with you now. It will help you to understand the topics clearly. Now the first topic is about the earth surface and its composition. See students, nearly 71% of the earth surface is covered up with water and the remaining 29% is covered of land. The large land masses are called continents. The vast water bodies surrounding the continents are called oceans. See, as you all know that we live on a unique planet called Earth. And why it is unique? Because it has all favorable conditions and it is the only planet in the solar system which have life on it. Now, this Earth is majorly covered of water. Nearly 71% of the Earth's surface is covered of water. And that's why it is regarded as blue planet sometime. Why? Because the large portion of the earth is covered of water, while the remaining 29% is covered of land. Now the huge land masses which you are seeing, if you will take the map, world map, you will see the huge land masses. That huge land masses are called continents. Okay. And now these continents are surrounded by the huge or large water bodies. And these large water bodies which surrounds the continents, they are known as oceans. Now, if you will see, at some places the land is flat and low-lying, while at other places it may be hilly or mountainous. See, it is very true. If you will move to Kashmir, the land surface is different because it is located in the mountainous or hilly areas. While if you will move to Punjab or Uttar Pradesh, as it is located in the plain area, the surface of the land is very flat. So the surface of land is not even, it is not same everywhere on the earth. Okay. Now, what are landforms? See, the natural features on the earth, on the surface of the land are called landforms. Yes. Whatever the natural features which you are seeing, whether that is a mountain, whether that is a plateau, whether that is a plain, all these major landforms which are present on the earth, these are known as the natural features of the earth, and as well as they are known as the landforms. So what are landforms? The natural features of the natural features which are found on the surface of the land. Simply, as they are formed by the natural process, that's why they are known as natural features. Okay. Now, the formation of landform is a slow and gradual process. It is very true. See, whether it is a mountain, whether it is a plain, whether it is a hilly areas, these all landforms, they are not formed in one day. It took millions of years. Okay. There are basically the two movements which are going on. Although I am just giving you for your knowledge, it is a brief description. See, landforms are not formed in one day. It is very true. It is a slow and gradual process. And the formation of landforms take millions of years. No doubt in this. And how these landforms are formed? Basically, they are formed by the two forces. See, you know that under the earth's surface, because of intense heat and temperature, there is a movement of plates, tectonic plates. So, because of the internal movement of the earth's surface and as well as the external movements on the earth's surface, there is a formation of landforms. Okay, the landforms, even today also, there is a change, there are some changes which are occurring on on the earth's surface, but we are not able to detect that because it is a slow and gradual process. Okay, that's why we are not able to detect the change. Okay. So the internal movement as well as the external movement are responsible behind the formation of the landforms. Now, although they, as I have mentioned you, it is a slow and gradual process, but there are some exceptional cases. Maybe some landforms may occur on the surface of the earth suddenly, like when flash flood occurs, or suppose your earthquakes takes place, so ultimately there will be some changes, okay? And that change is a sudden change. It has not taken a long time. It just appeared in a very short span of time. Now let's come to your continents. See, before moving to continents, I would like to show you this figure. This is of landforms. Here mountains are given, plains, this low flat land, it is a plain area. Now coastal plains, the plain which is located near the seashores. Okay, so these are the different landforms. Just have this picture, just have a look over this picture. You will see mountain, plains, coastal plains. These are the various landforms. Now let's come to this continents. See, evidence suggests that millions of years ago, all land masses on the surface of the earth were locked together as a great supercontinent called Pangaea. Pangaea is a Greek word meaning all lands. Similarly, all the oceans were also joined together, resulting in one world ocean called Panthalassa, a Greek word meaning all oceans. By about 200 million years ago, the supercontinent began breaking up into separate pieces that moved away from one another. These pieces slowly assumed their present position as the continents. Yes, see, not only evidence, even according to the scientific theory, the earth's surface, what you are seeing the present, if you will see, just I'm showing you, if you have atlas, just I'm showing you the present. Just have a look here. It is a world map. Sorry. Wait. Yes, it is a physical one and it is a political one. Now, it will be more clear to you. See, here you are seeing the seven continents: North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, Australia, and Antarctica. So, see, here just have a look here. What you are seeing, the present form of the seven continents, which you are seeing today, all these seven continents were not present million years ago. On the earth's surface, before 200 million years ago, there was no formation of all these structures, okay? According to scientists, all the lands which were present on the earth's surface, they were locked together. And because as all the lands were locked together, they were known as Pangaea. And the oceans, the five oceans which you are seeing today, they were also locked together and they were known as Panthalassa. Panthalassa is a Greek word which means all seas. All the five oceans which you are seeing today, they were locked together, okay? And these Pangaea simply means all lands in Greek. So as all lands were locked together, they were known as Pangaea, and all oceans, they were joined together and they formed just one ocean, and that was known as Panthalassa, okay? So what is Panthalassa? Different oceans, or you can say just the five oceans which we see today, they were all joined together and thus they were known as Panthalassa. So by 200 million years ago, you will see that they started drifting away from each other. They started, these landforms, they started moving away from each other and they started breaking into pieces. And they, in this process, the land was separated from one another. So gradually they assumed their present shape. Now I am just showing you here, just have a look in this picture, continental drift. Yes. Just have a look. See, continental drift theory is given, it is the name given by the scientist to this theory, although you will go through this theory in higher classes. Now let's just have a look. The first picture, it is of Pangaea, and it occurred 225 million years ago. Okay, so what you are seeing, all these seven continents, they were locked together. Okay, so all the lands were locked together, and that's why they were known as Pangaea. Now let's come to the second picture. In this second picture, what you will see that here 150 million years ago, what happened? The land was divided between two parts. One was Eurasia and the other was Gondwana land. So now there was a division of land into two parts. Now 100 million years ago, the third picture, it suggests that the land started now again because of the movement, they started breaking away from each other. And in present day, what you are seeing that these lands which were separated away because of the movements, now they assumed their present shape. That is your seven continents: North America, South America, Antarctica, Africa, Europe, Asia, Australia. Okay? I don't think so there is any confusion in this. Even in your book also, the picture is given. Here, just have a look. Here, the picture is given. So it was a slow and gradual process. See, suddenly it didn't happen. Okay, it was a gradual process. It took million years to get the present shape. Now continents are the most primary type of landform. There are seven continents on the earth, and see, most of the land masses are formed, if you will see the world map, you will see that most of the land masses are formed in the northern hemisphere. Okay, see, the earth is divided into two parts, and it is divided into two parts by the equator. Okay, see here, and just if you have a globe, you can easily see our earth is divided into two parts by the equator. Okay, and that is northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. So in the northern hemisphere, you will find most of the land masses are situated or located. Now, according to the size, if you will move, the continents which comes first is your Asia. Asia is the biggest continent both in size and population. Okay, after that there is Africa. After Africa there is North America, then it is South America, then it is Antarctica, then Europe, and finally Australia. So Australia is the smallest continent. Now let's come to the continents. Okay, so the first one is your Asia. See, Asia is the largest continent in the world, both in area as well as population. It covers about one third of the total land area on the earth. It lies in the eastern hemisphere. The landmass of Europe and Asia, when taken together, it is called Eurasia, means Europe plus Asia. The Arctic Ocean lies in its to its north, the Indian Ocean lies to its south, and the Pacific Ocean lies to its east. The Ural Mountains, the Caucasus Mountains, the Black Sea, and the Caspian Sea separate Asia from Europe. It was interlinked with Africa by the Isthmus of Suez. In the northeast, the Bering Strait separates Asia from North America. The highest mountain range in the world, the Himalayas, the highest mountain peak in the world, Mount Everest, as well as the lowest part of the earth, the Dead Sea, are all found in Asia. Yes. So Asia is the biggest continent both in terms of population as well as in terms of area. There is no doubt in this. See, this continent lies in the eastern hemisphere, and it covers one third of the total land on the earth. See, the Asia, when the landmass of Asia is taken together with Europe, it is known as Eurasia. Now, if you will move to the... Now, just have a look on this map. Now, if you will see the map given in your book, see here there is Asia, and to the south of Asia there is Indian Ocean. To the south of Asia, wait. To the south of Asia there is Indian Ocean, while to the east of Asia there is Pacific Ocean, and the north of Asia there is in the north direction there is Arctic Ocean. So on you are seeing that Asia being the largest continent, even it is surrounded by the major oceans of the world, whether that is Indian Ocean, which is located in the southern part, Pacific Ocean, which is located in the eastern part, or whether that is Arctic Ocean, which is located in the northern part. Now see, the Ural Mountains, the Caucasus Mountains, the Black Sea, the Caspian Sea, these are the major landforms which separates Asia. These are not only the landforms, even the water bodies like your Black Sea and Caspian Sea, these are the major landforms and water bodies which separates Asia from Europe. Now it was in the Asia, the continent, the Asian continent is interlinked with Africa by the isthmus of Suez. I will discuss about this isthmus. It is a type of water body, so I will discuss about this also. In the northeast, the Bering Strait separates Asia from North America. Yes, in the northeast, the Asia is separated from North America by the Bering Strait. The highest mountain range in the world, that is your Himalayas. The highest mountain peak in the world, that is your Mount Everest, while the lowest part of the earth, that is your Dead Sea. All these three major parts of the earth are found in the Asian continent. Okay, now let's come to Africa. Africa is the second largest continent in the world. See, a large part of Africa lies in the northern hemisphere. If you refer to an atlas, you will notice that it is the only continent through which all the three important latitudes, that is equator, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, passes. The prime meridian, that is 0 degree longitude, also passes through Africa. It is bound by Mediterranean Sea in the north, Red Sea in the northeast, the Indian Ocean in the east, and the Atlantic Ocean in the west. Now, Nile, one of the longest river in the world, flows through Africa. Sahara, the world's hottest desert, is located in the northern part of Africa. Now students, here I'm having the map of Africa. So as you all know, it is the second largest continent of the world, and see, the large part of the Africa, it lies in the northern hemisphere. And as I have mentioned you earlier also, that major part of the land you will find in the northern hemisphere. See, if you will see this continent, all three important latitudes passes, that whether that is your equator, see here, equator is this passing. Whether that is your here, see this equator, this is just passing through this continent. Now just have a look, Tropic of Cancer, here Tropic of Cancer, it is also passing through this continent here. Now let's move to this Tropic of Capricorn. All these three important latitudes, they all passes through your Africa. And even that prime meridian also, this line, the prime meridian, it also passes through Africa. Here, prime meridian. So students, if you will just go through, as I don't think so you have any problem in this latitudes. What is latitude? Equator is an imaginary line which divides the earth into two parts, okay, northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. What is Tropic of Cancer? The imaginary line which runs from east to west. And what is Tropic of Capricorn? The imaginary lines which runs from north to south. So whether that is Tropic of Cancer, latitude equator, or your Tropic of Capricorn. All these three important latitudes passes through Africa. So Africa is the only continent through which your three important latitudes, the three latitudes, that is your Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, and equator passes. Along with it, I have also shown you that Prime Meridian also passes through Africa. Now just have a look here. If you will see the map, I think so it's visible to every one of you. See here, Africa, if you will see the here, just have a look. In the northern part, it is north, it is south, it is west, it is east. So in the northern part, there is Mediterranean Sea. So Africa is bounded by Mediterranean Sea in the northern part. Then by the Red Sea in the northeastern part. Which is the northeast part? Here, as I have told you, it is north and it is east. So in the northeast part, it is located by Red Sea. Here you are seeing Red Sea. Now, Indian Ocean. Let's move to Indian Ocean. It is located in which part of the Africa? In the eastern part. This is eastern side. So here Indian Ocean is located. So on the eastern side, Africa is surrounded by Indian Ocean. Okay, and Atlantic Ocean in the west. Here, see, it is a western part. This is the western part. So here Atlantic Ocean is there. Now the world's largest desert, that is the world's largest and hottest desert, that is your Sahara. It is located in the northern part of Africa. And even the longest river in the world, that is Nile, that also flows through Africa. See here, Sahara Desert. Here it is a map. And here, see, in the northern part, the Sahara Desert is located. So through this Sahara Desert, the Tropic of Cancer passes. That's why it is one of the hottest desert in the world. Okay, the hottest desert of the world is your Sahara Desert. See, North America is the third largest and fourth most populated country in the world. So it is, in area wise, it is the third largest continent, as well as in the in terms of population, it is the fourth most populated continent in the world. This continent, it lies in the northern and western hemisphere. Okay, so it lies in the northern as well as the western hemisphere. It is surrounded by the Arctic Ocean in the north, the Pacific Ocean in the west, and the Atlantic Ocean in the east. Yes, just have a look here. This is a map of your North America. Okay, now just here have a look. In the, especially in the northern area, it is your northern part. See, in the northern part, there is your Arctic Ocean. Okay, Arctic Ocean lies in this northern part. While here in Atlantic Ocean, it is present in the eastern part. So North America is surrounded by Arctic Ocean in the northern part, Atlantic Ocean in the eastern part, and Pacific Ocean in the western part. Okay. Now, North America is linked to South America by a narrow strip of land called the Isthmus of Panama. Okay, the western side of America has mountain ranges stretching from the north to south. The Caribbean islands, also known as the West Indies, lie in the Gulf of Mexico. North America is also called the continent of five great lakes. Yes, so students, if you will see the map, just here, just have a look. Here it is North America. Here it is North America, here it is South America. See, North America is connected to South America by a narrow strip of land, which is called as Isthmus of Panama. Okay, what is isthmus? It is a landform which connects two big land masses. Okay, so here Isthmus of Panama is connecting North America and South America. Okay, now see. Now, see, the western side of America has mountain ranges which stretches from north to south, which runs from north to south. Now, the Caribbean islands, which is also known as West Indies and Caribbean island are same, okay? Don't get confused. So, it lies in the Gulf of Mexico. North America is known as continent of five great lakes. Just have a look here in this picture, given in your book. Just have a look here. It is the five great lakes. Okay, with that is Lake Huron, Ontario, Lake Erie, Lake Michigan, Lake Superior. These are the five great lakes which are found in North America, and that's why this continent is known as the land of five great lakes. Okay. Now let's come to South America. South America is the fourth largest continent. It lies mostly in the southern hemisphere. So it is the fourth largest continent in the terms of area, okay? And it lies most part of South America. It lies in the southern hemisphere. So if you refer to your atlas, you will note that the continent of South America is surrounded by oceans on almost all sides. Yes, just if you have a look, just have a look over this map. See, in the northern side there is Caribbean Sea. In the eastern side there is Atlantic Ocean. In the see here, just it is northern part, there is Caribbean Sea. Here in this, so just have a look here. This is the eastern part. This one is your eastern part. So here North Atlantic Ocean, and here there is South Atlantic Ocean. So in the eastern side, it is bounded by your Atlantic Ocean. And here in the western side, it is bounded by South Pacific Ocean. That is your Pacific Ocean. Okay. So this continent, South America, which is the fourth largest continent of the world, it is it is surrounded by sea almost on all sides. Why? Because on the northern side there is Caribbean Sea, in the eastern side it is having Atlantic Ocean, on the western side it is having Pacific Ocean. Okay. Now the world's longest mountain range, that is the Andes. The Andes are the world's longest mountain range. It runs in the western coast of the continent. Here, just have a look. This. You are seeing this brown color, it represents the Andes Mountain. Brown color is basically used for showing mountains. So here you are seeing this. So this is representing the largest range, that is your the Andes. Okay, the mountain range Andes here. So it is also found in South America. Now, the world's largest river in terms of the volume, that is your Amazon River. Yes, it also flows through the northern part of the continent, and the equator passes through Amazon. You may know this, the equator, which is a latitude, it passes through the Amazon River basin. Now, let's come to Antarctica. Okay. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent. It is Earth's southernmost continent, situated in the southern hemisphere, almost entirely south of the Antarctic Circle. The continent is roughly circular in shape and is surrounded by the Southern Ocean. The continent is almost 98% ice, hence it is also known as frozen continent or the void continent. It is colder than the Arctic, windswept, hostile, and surrounded by the stormiest sea. It is the coldest and the windiest part of the planet. India has set up three research centers here, which is Dakshin Gangotri, Maitri, and Bharati in Antarctica. Just if you see this map, what you will see that this continent, which is the fifth largest continent in the world, it is located in the southernmost point. Here it is South Pole, so it is located in the southernmost point of the Earth, and it is located, especially it is entirely located in the southern hemisphere.